This is experiment 11. It deals with reaction rates and equilibrium. Let's have a look at the pre-lab review. Question number one deals with specific safety alerts. Just one line is given for your answer, and that's the clue that there are no safety alerts in this experiment. Number two, disposal directions. You'd look for the garbage can icons. And these questions are pretty straightforward. And number six, how do you measure the amounts of reactant solutions? You'll count drops. And here are the data and report sheets now. Reaction rates, of course, are how fast something occurs. And over here, as you look in part A at the influence of concentration on reaction rates, you'll be recording reaction times in seconds. And notice that one of the reagents here has 5 drops, 10 drops, and 20 drops. Well, if we let 5 be the value C, this would be twice as much, or 2C, this would be 4 times as much, or 4C. And that's what I've entered for you here in this table 11.2 in the report. You'll determine the reaction rates, and then over here, when you look at concentration change and then reaction rate change, you'll be using words like double, triple, 4 times. Those will be fine. That's what the grader is looking for, that kind of terminology. In part B, the influence of temperature on reaction rates, you'll be recording temperatures. You can read the thermometers to the tenth, so be sure and record to that value. Reaction times will be recorded in seconds. And in the report part, again, follow those guidelines, temperatures to the tenth. Reaction rates you can calculate to 2 significant figures. And when it gets over here to the summary of that table, you'll use words like double, triple, one half, one third, so forth. That's what the grader will look for. Part C, the influence of catalysts on reaction rates. We're testing a number of substances on the left. We're looking at the rate of O2 evolution. And over here, we're sort of summarizing that catalytic activity. On the right, you'll use words high catalytic activity or no activity. So high and no would be fine as far as terminology. And on the left-hand side, I've put the note down at the bottom, use a plus minus scale. If there's lots and lots of catalytic activity, maybe 3 pluses and on down, 2 pluses, 1 plus, and a negative sign. Part D deals with equilibrium and Le Chatelier's principle. You'll be looking at color changes relative to a reference and recording red or brown or whatever the solution is colored. And over here on the right, the shift direction at equilibrium, you'll have to decide right or left. Table 11.9, you'll be looking for whether or not the solution is clear or cloudy, whether you see a precipitate or not. And in the report part, again, the shift direction of equilibrium, you would use the words right and left. And this brings us to the questions at the end. Some are hard. If you have questions, why, send me an email. Always do the experiments ahead of time so that we have time to exchange emails. And here's a little clue for number 5. Both A and B are correct, and I'd like you to tell me why. But do all of the questions as you complete the lab. Hope you have fun.